All right, guys, I'm on the other end of town here today. And just on a visual note, it appears up here on the right, coming into picture here, looks to be perhaps someone living in their car. Okay. Yeah, appears to be by himself. Okay. Well, I'm going to go speak with this man and see if I could perhaps offer him something to eat and maybe something cold to drink. And just talk to him for a minute. So I'll be right back. Let me get parked.
All right, guys, here's Home Depot. Back here's this is the old Walmart. The new Walmart's the one I'm normally at, and parked underneath the shade tree. But there's a gentleman here, appears to be living in his car. Can't see through any of the glass. He's sitting here in a chair. I don't believe I have met him before. Sir, how you doing today, buddy? Could you use a cold water? I'm sorry, I can't hear you.
That's fine.
Okay. Did you get any food? Are you hungry? I got lunches. I got some high protein stuff. There's a tuna pouch. There's a turkey and cheese, a bag of chips, a Kool-Aid pack, just miscellaneous snacks. I can go in for you. I mean, they're at my car. Let me give you one of my cards.
Sounds good.
All right, I'll set you up. I just talk people out whenever I can. And you haven't been here that long, have you?
I've been out here for over a year.
I mean, like, parked right here?
Yeah, out here for over a year.
Really? Well, I must have missed you. I've been here a few times. But all right, well, let me get you that lunch. And then I'll see if there's anything else that you may need. I got soap and shampoo and that type of thing. Yeah. Is the car broke down or just the battery dead or?
Well, I got the battery replaced. I got replaced. I still have my insurance sticker on the check.
So, I mean, so it runs? All right, good. Good deal. All right. Well, let me chit that lunch and I'll be right back. Poor guy. Very soft spoken, hard to hear. Said he's been homeless for about a year. Said he's been there quite a while. Got a Slim Jim, we got an orange, some grape Kool-Aid, lemon pepper chunk light tuna with a fork. About to get ran over, but they said, go ahead. I got an orange in there too. If you want to go ahead and peek through there, I just made everything today. You know, it's all nice and fresh. You say some shampoo and soap?
I got shampoo and soap.
You have both? Okay. What about socks? How are you doing on socks?
Got socks too.
Yeah.
Got blankets and stuff.
What do you think you need most, sir?
Basically, right now, I'm just trying to find a place to live.
I'm seeing that more and more often. A lot of people are just struggling to, you know, they might get a check and whatnot, but they just can't afford rent. It has skyrocketed. If you can even find a place, it's beyond your, you know, even a crappy place. You can't even get into it because you can't afford the down payment and the, you know, that type of deal. I'll tell you what, I do have my friend Dorothy in Texas, that's a $10 Walmart gift card. So you use that at your own leisure. If there's anything you'd like to get on the side. But can I ask your name, please?
Steve.
Steve, my name's Daryl. It's nice to meet you, sir. Been out here a year, eh?
Yeah.
What happened?
Well, my mom, she passed away a little over 4 years ago. And a year later, I lost my apartment. Couldn't keep up the rent.
Wow.
I was working for Walmart. Got fired from there because somebody broke into my office last year. went to Ally Security Company, got a job with them. Went around the Valentine's Day last year. Looked at the whole thing.
Unbelievable.
During the summertime, before Thanksgiving, legs started swelling up. Those fluids were building up in my leg.
Fluids were building up in your leg? Really?
I got to spend 11 days in the hospital because when I got my legs checked out, right on Thanksgiving Day, I got to where I couldn't breathe.
Oh, Lord.
So I had to go back to the hospital. Blood clots on my lungs.
Blood clots on your lungs. Oh, my Lord.
I'm supposed to be on blood donation. I was looking at $650 for that night.
Meds are skyrocketing. It's...
Everything
is, it seems to be geared towards failure. You know, there's not much to look forward to, you know, a lot of days. All right.
Well, my social security, yeah, just got started. I'm 62 in June.
You'll be 62 in June? Oh, you turned 62. Okay. So now you can qualify? You getting your paperwork? All that?
Checks,
oh, fantastic. You just need a bed. You know, you need a place. Wow. Have you tried any services at Greater Works or the Salvation Army?
I tried Salvation Army and I tried Providence. Just didn't get the words.
Okay, what about Cox's Rentals over on Morris Street? They've got a lot of week-to-week and month-to-month type no-lease places that just pop up all the time.
I didn't even know about that.
Yeah, I'll tell you what. Give me a few minutes. Do you have a phone? Okay, I'll dig up their phone number for you, and you can just call. And you know, they might say call next month, but they always say call at the beginning of the month. And lo and behold, here it is, the beginning of the month. Perfect time. Let me. My phone's in the car. I'll go dig up that phone number. I'll write it down for you. I'll be right back. That's the least I could do. Seems like a very nice man. Worked for a security company, so he's got skills. Poor fellow. Here you go, Steve. They're about 5 miles from here. It's Cox Rentals. And there's a phone number for you. And you know, they do help quite a people, but you know, a bunch of people. But I don't know the quality of their places. A lot of people don't like them, but it's a place. You know, could you use a Dr. Thunder or a Mountain Lightning soft drink? Which or I got regular cola also. Which your favorite? Haven't even thought about it. All right, we'll make it a surprise. All right, I'll be right back. Could have saved a trip if I asked him beforehand. I think my demise one day will be getting hit by a car. Sometimes I get so focused on what I'm doing, I don't pay attention to the obvious. Just saying. Boy. Doesn't seem to really need much. I mean, anything that I could really have to offer. Here you go, sir.
Thank you.
I wasn't gonna say I'll offer you a Bible, but looks like you have a couple up there. Good deal. All right. Kind of an odd question. Do you need a pen? I see you have a notebook there in your door. Would you like, I mean, do you take note? You got a pen? Okay. Boy, you looks like you're pretty packed. Looks like you're pretty equipped. So.
Some of already have with me. Some of you
acquire in your journey. Well, I'll tell you what. I'm by here every so often. Is it alright if I stop and check on you every now and then? Hopefully next time I come here, you're not here. You know, but I would try to get a hold of them. You know, it's still you know, kind of early in the day yet, and it is the first. They always say call on the first. So now might be prime pickings. You never know. Strange things happen for a reason. So, Steve, it's a pleasure to meet you, sir. All right, is there anything else I can do for you? Okay. Well, I guess as maybe the days go on, and hopefully they won't, you know, next time I see you, maybe see what we can do about figuring out a plan. And if you need to, if you get a hold of them and they want you to go down there and talk to them, my email address is on the front of that card. Okay, you can email me. I'll come get you and I'll drive you over there. Does that sound fair? All right, I'll be more than willing to do that for you. All right, well, take care. At least you got some cooler weather to deal with as opposed to the boiling sun. You know, I think we're at today's high of about 72. So, all right. Then you have a great day, sir. And I hope I see you again, but under better circumstances. So, all right, have a good day. You're welcome. Like I said, I told you I'm gonna get hit by a car. I stopped to pick up some garbage and wasn't even looking. Man, my heart skipped a beat. That was close. He was cruising though. But then again, I guess that's probably why you don't walk in front of him. All right, guys. Man. Oh boy. There's got to be some type of affordable housing, you know. I don't understand. It's crazy. Okay, well, it's only 11:15. I got things to do. I got some more food. All right, I'm going to continue on. This is basically the first stop of the day. All right, be back in a minute.